Right, so hello all, good morning and welcome to another session with me, Varun, on TechTablet. And in this session, we would be looking and we would be understanding a bit more on data science. And when I say data science, in the last video, we've already covered the topics, that is decision tree and random forest. And in this video in specific, we will be talking about naive-based theorem. I really hope you enjoy the series and also that you learn something new. Well, this is a small attempt for all the developers who are looking forward for their career or who are looking forward for some scope in data science, right? So I really hope that this helps the developer community and also all the people who are looking for an interview or, you know, anything on this. Well, so the agenda would be to understand what is naive-based and the concepts related to naive-based theorem, followed by some example and case studies. And we'll also look at some different types of naive-based, and we'll understand some basic mathematical explanation and any stuff related to naive-based, right? So for all those of you who do not know me, guys, well, I am a developer. I was an SAP ABAP developer followed by SAP UI 5. Then I got onto YouTubing. Then I became a corporate trainer. And finally, now I am a data scientist. And in this video learning series, we would be looking at R language, Python, TensorFlow, interview questions, and also we would cover the topics one by one. So firstly, irrespective of R or Python, we would be looking at the topics which are in general covered throughout data science. So it would be all these topics like regression models, different classification models, how to understand what is a decision tree, what is random forest. We'll understand all the concepts which are common between R and Python, and then we'll go on to specifications, and then we'll also look at the development pattern. So all those who are interested, guys, hit the subscribe button and hit the like button to let us know that you like the videos and also let your friends know about it. So let's hit the floor. Well, so understand what is naive-based. Firstly, naive-based classifiers that we're talking about, they are a set of algorithms. It's not just one algorithm or it's not just one formula because of which naive-based is possible, right? It is a group, it's a collection of different logics and different entities at one place, and wherein, you know, all of these together, they start classifying the data that's being sent into, and what is it that they see? Through this theorem, we find the probability of an event, and we see if that, you know, the event which we are finding the probability of, if, you know, another event has already occurred, something like that, or not. Okay, just to reiterate what is here, it finds the probability of an event occurring given that the probability of another event has already occurred. So now let us say X and Y are two events. Now if you say X is an event which would be occurring, it would be seeing would X occur on the basis of Y, right? So each and every time you are trying to remove something or you want to highlight something or classify something, it would check for some previous instances of the same. Now, just to take a look at the formula, well, this is how it looks. So you have the posterior probability, which is onto the LHS. And then you have the predictor probability, which is P of X, the entire space, right? Now, why do we have this name, which is naive base? Why naive, right? See, because you are not sure if the data that you have or if the, you know, output that you have is correct or not. It is mostly a probability, and the probability is just kept the way it is. We do not try to challenge on the fact that the given output is 100% correct. Now, talking about what can this do and how does naive-based do this? Well, to be very honest, there is very little training or exposure available on naive-based as compared to other classification methods, at least as of now. But then, what you can do before you start working on a model is you try to find the parameters for the features wherein the individual probability distribution can be, or, you know, is found. You just have to find the individual probability distribution of the events that would be occurring, right? Now, when you do this, it means that naive-based would be performing extremely well when the data is really high or huge data, and also notwithstanding the quantity of data, it would even be able to handle high dimensional data points, which is not something, you know, very common in data science as of now, at least. Okay, so just to understand what this is mathematically, let us say just a while back when we were talking about an event happening with X and Y, here I've taken another example of A and B. Well, it's not an example, it's an explanation. So here we find the probability of A happening given that B has already happened. And here B is the evidence while A is the hypothesis. So evidence is something that's already happened. Hypothesis is a prediction that you're making on the basis of something that has happened, right? So the assumption here is that the predictors or the features, they are totally independent. And that is presence of one of a particular feature which does not affect the other. Hence, it's called naive. And the output cannot be challenged. It might be right or it might be wrong. For example, you can just consider the case study of spam classifier. You know, we all know what a spam is, right? Now, when you talk about spam classifier, not every time your spam is classified 100% successfully. No matter what, you still see that some spam messages finally find their way through, you know, the inbox. You see that in your inbox you have spams, probably less, but then you still. Okay, so this is the biggest challenge. Well, now talking about some applications where naive Bayes is pretty commonly used. Firstly, you have real-time predictions. Secondly, you have multi-class predictions. It's used in text classification, that is text mining, or probably spam filtering. We were just talking about spam filtering, right? That is your email spam detection. It also is used in sentiment analysis and recommendation system. Well, let's take things from the downside. When you talk about recommendation system, here you have another filtering approach, that is collaborative filtering and naive-based classifier, which are used together to build a machine learning or to build a data mining or to build a, you know, text mining variant of a model, right? Then talking about text classification or spam filtering. So here there are certain keywords which each and every, now let us say you are using Yahoo or probably Google. There are certain keywords which are fed into, and every time these keywords are repeated, your inbox or your Yahoo mail, your Google mail, they ensure that these words, if they are occurring multiple number of times, they are removed from the process of getting delivered into your inbox. Now, if the person who is, you know, writing the spam, or if the person who's creating the spam, he happens to use a completely new set of terminology, in that case, spam filtering would not be very successful because there is no event occurring. So A would not be able to, I mean, the evidence cannot be established, hence the predictor would fail. So these are some things that you have to understand going forward. Understanding or looking at the different types of naive Bayes classifiers. Well, we have multinomial naive Bayes classifier, Bernoulli's naive Bayes, and Gaussian naive Bayes. Well, as of now, talking about how raw the market is and talking about how new data science is, it would be very wrong on my part to say that each of these variants is extensively worked upon, but then yes, these models are definitely being used independently in the current data science parlance. And if you want to use the data science, if you want to use the naive Bayes classifier, then just try to pause the video for a second and hit, and can you just try to remember what is the library it is? And if you are able to remember, please write that in the comment section below. Now, if after the pause, if you're not able to remember, well, it is E1071. Okay, you can use that, and then you can just use naive Bayes, and it should be able to take in. Now, talking about multinomial naive Bayes model or multinomial naive Bayes classifier in specific, this is mostly used when you want to classify a document. Okay, now again, when you say a document, this document could be belonging to any variant or, you know, any category. The feature or the predictors which are used by the classifier occur on the frequency of the words that are available or that are present in the document. So what do we mean by the last statement? It means that greater the number of words which are being repeated, right, the greater your prediction would be, because the event has given very strong evidence for the predictor, right? Then talking about Bernoulli's naive Bayes, this is very similar, or this can be very easily compared to multinomial naive Bayes. But here, the predictors are Boolean. It's either 0 or 1. There is no other thought that we can apply here. And this is, you know, just used to either remove or add, or probably, you know, log in or log out. It's used for very decisive things, wherein you do an action and it would only be a yes or a no. There's no third variant. Well, then you have the Gaussian naive Bayes, and here talking about the predictors, they take up continuous values and they are not discrete from each other. Here we assume that these values are sampled, or these values are taken from the whole lot from a Gaussian distribution method. Right, and talking about some disadvantages and advantages about naive Bayes. Well, as we know, there's no model which you know, which goes without an exception. So the same happens to naive Bayes too. So the first disadvantage is that this classifier makes a very strong assumption on the shape or on the basis of your data distribution, right? And because of this, you have a good potential of the data being misclassified, right? Secondly, if your data is scarce, right, or if your data is scarce, well, in that case also, you might have your data, or you might have your prediction to be going wrong. The third problem arises for continuous features. Now, when you say continuous features, you know, what I mean to say is, if you're not able to make them discrete, okay, if you're not careful, you can, you know, really throw away a lot of information. There's a high possibility that a lot of information might be skipped and might not be considered at all. Now, this is the place where we use Gaussian distribution models, okay? So, yeah, these are some, you know, very basic disadvantages we have. And talking about advantages, well, the most biggest advantage that we have is it's super simple. It's really easy. It can do huge calculations at a very great speed, and really it makes it look, you know, it gives a look as if the calculation is very easy. Okay. And if naive Bayes conditional independence assumption actually holds, then it will give you a model which is, you know, quicker than discriminative models. For example, logistic regression, all of these, they need a bit of more training time as compared to naive Bayes. Okay. So yeah, this is the thing that I wanted to talk to you about in this video. Okay. Now I want you people to think about a very simple question. That is, why is logistic regression better than naive Bayes in that case? Right. Now, if you can just think about it and write in the comment section below, we'll try to answer this in the next video, right? So thanks a lot, each and every person, for being there and for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. In the upcoming video, we would be looking at confusion matrix, what is bagging, and other stuff related to data science. If in case you like the video, hit the like button to encourage us and to let us know that you've understood the video. And if in case you have any queries, please use the comment section below. And if you feel that this might be useful for any of your friends, please hit the share button, as the aim is to let people know that there is something like TechTablet existing, wherein it's a developers forum trying to help people just to understand some basic concepts and foundations. This is me, Varun Rao, logging off. Have a great day, each and everyone.